First thing I want you to do is I want you to seek God's face. I want you to pray. And I want you to ask the Lord, Father, what is it that you want me to do? How can I make a difference? Lord, I'm not a preacher. I'm not this. I'm not that. What is it that I can do? First thing I want you to do is go to the Lord. Lay before him.
Yeah.
Ask for direction. Because the Bible clearly tells us the steps of good men are ordered by God. Lord, am I in the right place? Am I doing the right things? You know. What would you have me to do? And then I want you to get still. And I want you to hear God. Wait until you hear the voice of God. And then I want you to be involved in ministry. I want you to be involved here in whatever capacity God directs you to go. But we've got to do this. We've got to go out. We've got to knock doors. We've got to do things that a lot of folks are not comfortable with. But if we're going to save the lives of young folk, we got to go to where the young people are. Moses was in the desert of Midian, but the ministry was back in Egypt. If he was going to help people, he had to go back to where the needs were. That's exactly what we got to do. We can't stop this. We can't relent. We can't lighten up. We had one function. So what was the function for? Just a one-time event? We see you next year at the same time? No. But we got to keep pounding the pavement. We got to keep going door to door. You can join forces with the Jonah Street Ministry. You can go out with us and we can talk with people and we can pray on that property silently within ourselves as we walk up. We can pray up and down this community. Pray up and down the other communities where all of the children seem to be hating one another. We can go there. There is something very powerful about prayer.
Yes.
Old people used to say prayer changes things.
Yes.
And I know prayer changes things. Coming in here to have a church on Sunday morning, having good fellowship is a wonderful thing. But if the extent of our ministry is singing a good song and giving a few hugs at the appropriate time, and when we leave here we don't see each other again until 6 or 7 days later, then all of this is in vain. We might as well get the lights and find somewhere else. But real ministry is when we leave this place. Because our children are dying and parents are crying.
Hallelujah.
And they're calling us to make a difference. And we're going to do that.
Hallelujah.
And the next thing you're going to do is you're going to give of yourselves into the lives of others. You're going to be that person on the telephone. You're going to be that one that's assigned to ones. You're going to be that one that's going to be that confidant. You're going to be the one that's going to befriend that person that's hurting so. We got to do something, folks. You know, these children over in youth church, oftentimes we got more kids over there than we have people to work with them. But do you know that you can make a difference in the lives of those children right now while they're here before they get up? All you gotta do is just go be a part of it. Let's grab them while they're kids. Grab them while they're young. Let's be friendly now. Let's see if we can change their lives now before they get to that point. Let's do what we can to save them now. Let's get involved. Let's give of our time. Give of our energy. Let's make a difference. Come, Pastor, what can I do? How can I work? You know, I'm ready to do that now. Because as we go out and pave and we go out and beat the pavement and we go out and pray for those that when they come in here, then we got to work with them. We got to spend time with them. So we need you to do that now. Well, I'm going to stop. I feel the need to pray for them. But folks, I passed by this morning on the way. I was telling one of my other sons back the other day. One of my other boys was riding with me on the weekends. And I said, we passed by the little kids on the street. I said, you see the children out here? 7 kids we passed by. They don't go to church anyplace. You see the young adults sitting on the porches and congregating with their cars. I said, you see where they are? Some of them are ours. I said, they're not here. I said, man, we got a lot of work to do. You know, how can we expect it to change lives until we first change attitudes? Man, we got some work to do. So I want you to be with me. I want you to rally with me. And let's make a difference here. Let's hear the voice of God. Wherever you are right now, it could be God calling you. You know, I think sometimes the greatest fulfillment that we get out of life is hearing from God and doing with our lives what God wants us to do. And right now, if you've ever been needed in ministry, God knows you need it now.
Amen.
All right, I'm gonna pray for you. We'll pick up next week, God say so, and we'll begin the series. But right now, I want to pray for you. If you're here today and you're hurting, you're suffering, you've been impacted by some of this that's going on, I want to pray for you. Obviously, God's going to bring you through where you are. That's not the real issue. The real issue is that when God does bring you through, will you be used of God? Will you allow God to use you to help somebody else? Let me pray for you this morning. Let's pray together. If you have any problems that you need us to agree with you on, I want you to come down. Let's pray. Let's pray together.
Amen.
I'm not going to anoint you this morning. We're just going to pray together. We're going to pray for Rose and the families of all the others. The one that we lost back here, there's so many. Thomas, we're going to just pray. Let me tell you people something. Let me give you a word of encouragement here. Now, we're grieving, I'm sure, so. Let me tell you something. The devil does not win.
Oh, Jesus.
He doesn't have to.
No.
So it's okay that you cry. That's fine. But don't cry as if there is no hope.
Amen.
Because we have hope.
Amen.
And we are going to make a difference, James.
Amen.
We're going to put, you know, we will never stop the devil from doing what all, you know, the things that he is doing. God's going to stop that. But we can change folks' attitudes. We can stop folks from allowing the devil to manipulate them. We're not going to stop until we do that. You know, our lives are going to be, you know, one, you know, we're changing our own lives. We're living in such a way that when our young folk look at us, they see Jesus.
Amen.
I want to live so holy that when you look at me, you can't see anything but Jesus.
Amen.
That when I'm talking with you, the witness that is on the inside of me will touch the witness on the inside of you. And then a difference has to be made.
Yes. Amen.
Do you think so, all?
Yes.
See? We're going to be that way. So when we approach them, the enemy sees us coming, he's going to fear us.
Yeah.
We're not going to go down there with our head hung down and saying, they were asking me last night, Pastor, what do you think? Is there an end to this? I just looked at them. I just walked on off. There's no time to try to convince anybody that this is a losing proposition. It is not.
Amen.
And if we Christians or the church, you know, approach ministry with a defeatist attitude, then we've already lost. We've conceded to the devil. And he certainly will win and destroy and wreak havoc in our kids' lives. But we already have the victory.
Amen.
Do you believe that?
Amen.
Yes.
We got the victory. Right?
Yes.
Amen.
We got the victory. We're going to save these children's lives. If we don't save them all, by God, we're going to save as many as we can. Somebody say, well, I think the chief said last night, well, Pastor Haire, if you can make a difference with one, you've done your job. You know, I like Bob Timmy. He lives around the corner from us. I like Bob Timmy, but by God, one, we're not out here to save one. We're out here to fill the house.
Woo. Amen.
The Lord said, go from alley to alley and fight the men, the cripple, the halt, the maimed, and bite them all in. And he said, well, we've done all that. And he said, well, then go back to every highway and every hedge and invite all the others to come in so that the house will be full. God ain't interested in just getting one. We got to keep working. We got to keep going. We got to keep giving. We got to keep living holy. We got to keep preaching and propagating the message of truth and life. Until we get as many to hear the gospel and get as many changed as we can.
Jesus.
So we're not going to stop. The plan is already in place. We're not going to relent. And in time, we're going to come together again. show you where we're going next. Right now, we're going to let the devil know that he has no victory over us.
Amen, amen.
He steal our children from us.
Amen.
Don't do that. He's going to like, I'm tired of killing our kids.
Jesus.
And so we're going to fight this thing.
Jesus. Amen.
Agree with at least one person beside you. So Father, I stand before you this morning, as I've done so many times today, humble and sincere as I know how to, Father. Lord, I bow my head before you this morning to, first of all, Lord, to say thank you for still being good to us.
Thank you.
Lord, you know you are the mighty God. You're the great God.
Yes.
And there's none like you.
Yes.
We appreciate you, Lord. We appreciate this opportunity to be able to talk to you.
Thank you
for being there for us, Father. Thank you for not only hearing our prayers, Lord, but you answer them.
Thank you, Lord.
Today we stand before you, Lord, with our hearts maybe somewhat heavy, but God, within our spirits, we are lifted up because we know that we are empowered by you to make a difference in the lives.
Thank you, Lord.
This morning, Lord, I just say, like all of these others that are standing before you, Father, whatever you want us to do, please tell us. And wherever you want us to go, Lord, please show us. We make ourselves available to you, Lord, that you can use us as vessels, as witnesses, to carry the truth of salvation to the lives of these young folk, so that they are changed from where they are. Captivated emotionally and psychologically by the enemy, by Satan. Into a life of peace and tranquility, which comes through the knowledge of your Son, Lord Jesus, and an eternal relationship with you, God. And I don't pray this for your benefit, but for those who are listening to me this morning.
Jesus.
I say, Lord, examine our lives. Father, if you find anything within us that's not pleasing to you, something that would hurt our
lives,
something that would render us ineffective to carry the good news to those who need it most, I pray you let us know what it is, my Father, so we can cut out every weight and every sin that stands between us and you. We don't want to think wrong, my Father. Not only do we not want to act wrong, but we don't even want to think wrong. We want to live as close to perfect as we possibly can for you with the help of your Son, Lord Jesus. We love you this morning, Father. We've sinned against you by words, deeds, or actions. It is my prayer this morning that you forgive us and have mercy upon us. We've sinned by commission or omission. Lord, please forgive us and have mercy upon us. Keep your anointing upon us afresh every day so that we can be more and more like your Son, Lord Jesus. Now, Father, I pray for these that are standing around this altar that we've dedicated to you. You know what their needs are. You knew that before they stood to come down this way. The Lord, you told us to pray for one another, so that's what I'm doing, Father. I'm praying for these that you've assigned to me and the others who are not even here this morning, God. You know what all of them are going through. I pray for Rose and her family, those that are hurting, as I've done so many times leading into this time of prayer, Lord, that you would comfort them as only you know how.
Yeah.
Give those of us who are going to be visiting with them the words of comfort to say, Lord, if there are any, you use us, Lord, to bring some type of comfort or solace into their lives. Your will be done in all things. It's times like these, Lord, when we find ourselves helpless standing before you. And if you don't fill us,
hallelujah,
if you don't lift us up, if you don't fill us, Father, where can we go? We need you, Father. Oh, God, thank you.
Thank you
for always being there for us.
And
it's at these times that we realize how weak and frail we really are. We do need you, my Father. We need you so much, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
We can't even live before you, God, without your help. We can't live freely, Holy Spirit. You help us to live freely, Holy Spirit. But we have a mind. We have a desire to please you. We want you to be proud of us. We want you to be pleased with the way we're living our lives. Satisfied with our witness. We want you to be satisfied. And so it is our prayer today, my Father, that you encourage these that you've assigned to them.
Thank you, Lord.
Make them ready.
Yes.
Ready in their hearts and in their minds. To make a difference in this world.
Yes.
Now, I don't have to pray for any sickness. I don't have to pray for their needs. I've done that, Lord, because you're already taking care of them.
Thank you, Father.
But I pray now, my Father, that instead of us asking you, Lord, we're standing before you now saying, Lord, what would you have of us to do?
Yes.
How How can we be of any service to you, my Lord?
Thank you, Lord.
To make a difference in the lives of your people. You are heard your word say that when we've done what you require to the least of your children, which means when we've done what you require to those that we see and touch, our brethren, that we've done it unto you. You let us know what we can do. We want to
thank you, Lord.
And we'll give you praise.
Yes.
Well, thank you so much for listening, Lord.
Yes. Thank you, Father.
When we leave this place, we know we're not leaving your presence. We know that you're going to go with us.
Oh, no, Lord.
I pray for these children that are here.
Yes. Oh, yes. Yes.
And I pray for the rest of these young adults in this church, Lord.
Yes.
I pray, Lord, that you help us to bring a stop to the pain.
Yes.
That is in this church, in this congregation.
Yes.
We've had so much, Lord. Now, I'm begging you, Father, please show us what to do.
Thank you, Lord.
Stop this.
Thank you, Lord.
That we can stand against it.
Thank you, Lord.
Stand against
it.
I stand bold in this morning.
Thank you, Lord.
As your ambassador, and I speak clearly against it.
Yes.
Power of the Holy Ghost inside.
Thank you.
I tell the devil, you might as well stake your hand because you're not going to win.
Jesus.
Victory is not yours. Victory belongs to us.
Yes.
So I pray, Lord, that you embolden us. Save our children's lives.
Thank
Save
you.
The hand of death from this ministry.
Oh, Lord.
Keep your children's hearts.
Yes.
Keep their minds. Lord, that's what I pray.
Oh,
Lord.
In the name of Jesus.
Thank you. Encourage your heart.
Open their hearts so they receive him.
Thank you, Lord.
Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
The children are far and near.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you,
yes.
So thank you for listening to us.
Hallelujah.
Always be blessed and praise you in your Son, Lord Jesus, in mighty precious name. Now may the grace of God
Hallelujah.
And the sweet communion of His Holy Spirit rest, rule, and abide with them all.
Yes.
Now, henceforth, and forever, if you love the Lord, say amen.
Yeah. Yeah.
I want you to hug somebody beside you. Tell them you love them. Tell them you love them.